An old conference rivalry renews this evening as the Marshall Thundering Herd make the 3.5-hour journey northwest to Oxford, Ohio to take on the Miami RedHawks here on a beautiful night for basketball here in Oxford. Miami and Marshall here on RedHawk Radio. Luke West, Poley, Zach Ringers alongside. Zach, first meeting between these two storied rivals since 2005. Hard to believe it's been that long between a pair of programs that seem to have known each other very, very well over the years, but really just a pair of comparable teams in terms of their results. Definitely not comparable, though, in terms of the makeup. Marshall, a team full of vets. They're returning their top three scorers. Miami, a team filled with newcomers, as we've seen from the early goings.
Yeah, and this is really going to be a good litmus test game for the RedHawks, Luke. Obviously, these are two teams. They come into this series. Miami actually leads the series 47-28. Like you mentioned, a great rivalry to kind of get rekindled. We haven't seen a meeting of these two teams since 2005, but you're absolutely right, Luke. This is a seasoned veteran team from Marshall. Miami is still figuring out what they got. They gave Georgia just about all they could handle in the other Athens down south a few nights ago, and that was really a good game to see from this Miami team that played a less than impressive first half against an NAIA team in Goshen. They lost to Evansville at home. It seems like they're finally finding their stride, but it's about time to really test up against a team that will match up well against them, like the Marshall Thundering Herd, and this will be a fun one here from Millett Hall.
Absolutely. Let's talk about that game against Georgia. The RedHawks came up just short, lost 77-70, but like you said, some performances to really like, most notably Makai Larry, 34 points for the RedHawks, the highest of any member of this team all season.
Yeah, and really, Luke, if you look at that game and you watch the second half, they played just about as well as they could against Georgia. It was just a matter of Power 5 commits that are bigger, faster, stronger than a team like Miami. But really, like we said, Miami gave them all they could handle. Makai Larry, what's not to love, still has not missed a free throw on the year. Ice cold down the stretch, 34 points for him. I think the one thing you can circle from that game was the rebounding at times could have been better, but nonetheless, it was still a good showing from the RedHawks, and I think you really got to like what you saw in Athens from this team.
Yeah, you mentioned the talent disparity in that rebounding. 18 offensive rebounds for Georgia. Miami only had 19 on the defensive side total, so they were nearly out-rebounded on their own backcourt by the Bulldogs, and they came up short in that one. Not going to win you too many games. RedHawks and Thundering Herd set to go here from Millett Hall. Pretty solid crowd on hand here on a Thursday night. Miami in the home white uniforms, back with the red accents. Miami across the front with the numbers on front and back. Marshall in the sharp road black uniforms with the script Marshall in white with green accents along the front script numbers in the front and back. And the script M on the shorts for the Thundering Herd. Nice black alternate uniforms for Marshall, team that's 1-1 overall coming off their first win of the season. It came on Monday back in Huntington, 91-65, a dominant decision over Tennessee Tech. Their first game of the year was a loss to a first-year D1 program, Queens University of Charlotte in North Carolina, picked up their first win as a Division I program against these Marshall Thundering Herd just last week.
And Luke, we were talking about it off air. This is a huge team from Marshall. Multiple guys listed over 7 foot, a couple guys at 6'10 as well. This is really gonna be a fun matchup, and RedHawks are gonna have to rebound very well in this one.
Marshall has gone with the same starting five all season. They're gonna do the same here tonight. For the RedHawks, it'll be Smith, Mabry, Larry, Lewis, and Marambo. And as Marshall wins the tip, it'll be Taylor, Kerfman, and Achille Killen, and Handlington. Thundering Herd win the tip, and we are underway here from Millett Hall. Floated into the high post, a hand to the far elbow. Floater shot rattles around the rim and goes for Andrew Taylor, the redshirt senior who has started 80 games for Marshall. In 80 career appearances, gets the Thundering Herd on the board. For the RedHawks, back on the offensive side, Julian Lewis finds Makai Larry. Larry double-teamed, able to split through, but lost the ball in the process. Now here come the Thundering Herd and a Chili Killen. Lost it, racing up the court as that ball was stripped away. Last touch coming from Miami's Billy Smith as it goes out the baseline. It'll be an inbound for Marshall underneath the Miami basket.
Yeah, and we saw Julian Lewis on the offensive side. He's going to be big. He fouled out in that game against Georgia, and it really hurt down the stretch for that team that was lacking depth and still is due to a lot of injuries. There, he's going to be a big one tonight.
Off the inbound, quick corner three opens up, and it's knocked down by Camden Kerfman, the VMI transfer, who's averaging 12.5 points per game this season and nearly 40% from beyond the arc. Puts Marshall out in front 5-0. Arambo hands it off. Off-balance attempt towards the middle. Rolls out of bounds from Billy Smith. Was it tipped? They say it was. And it will go out the baseline. Red Hawks retain possession. 18:58 to go. 5-0 Thundering Herd. Inbounding from the near corner. Quick pass from Larry to Mabry. Now near the free throw line and the elbow kick to the corner. It's back to Mabry. Mabry turning around, having a lot of trouble. Just sends it out to Marambo. Sends a deep three and it's short. And the rebound is picked up for Marshall by Hadlington. Up the far side of the court, Andrew Taylor, the Corbin, Kentucky native, skies one to the near side. And a Chili Killen came down with it, passed it off, but that pass was tipped and now taken away. Here come the RedHawks. Lewis out wide to Smith. Smith back to Lewis in the near corner. Spinning, now driving down the baseline, lost it and regained before that ball could get out of bounds. Now the RedHawks will send it back out to Mabry. Mabry comes off the screen, doesn't get a lot of room. Fake shot, instead sends it into the post. Marambo going to work with the left hand. He's blocked. And a Chili Killen, the Nigerian, with the rejection. Here comes Marshall the other way. And a Chili Killen got it underneath the basket and lost it. Stripped away from Miami by Julian Lewis. Fast-paced opening few minutes, 17:57 to go. Marshall leading 5-0. RedHawks still looking for the first basket. Marambo into the near corner. Larry for three, rolls around, no good. Rebounded offensively by Miami. Lewis's attempt is blocked, and it is picked up by Marshall. Really solid defense from the Herd early on. Camden Kerfman now into the corner to the upper wing for Hadlington, who hands it off to Andrew Taylor. Taylor with Mabry on him, lost it off the screen, nearly went into the Miami bench, but he recovers. Taylor hands it off on the upper wing. Kerfman to the top of the key and now into the corner. Three ball is no good. Rebounded by Marshall. His shot attempt put up is tipped out of bounds, but the last touch will come from the Thundering Herd. And the RedHawks catch a break with 17:18 to go. It'll be Miami ball.
Great defensive set from the RedHawks there, Luke. And what I'm liking so far is that the size from Marshall has not put them at a severe disadvantage on the rebounding. They've still held their own, and they're doing a great job right now.
Still looking for basket number one, nearly 3 minutes in. Here's Mabry at the top of the key. Mabry one-hands it over to the elbow. Marambo sent it down low, and a foul is called on the floor. RedHawks will inbound from the baseline. Reaching in there was Camden Kerfman. His first. Team first foul for Marshall. Off the inbound, in the post, Marambo drives to the paint. Skyhook is rejected. Micah Hadlington with the second block of the game here in the opening minutes for the Thundering Herd. Tavion Kinsey now, their leading scorer, pulls up an awkward attempt that he pulled down, tried to pass, and that one just tipped away from the intended target. It'll fly out of bounds. Tavion Kinsey, the Columbus, Ohio native, fifth-year senior, first-team All-Conference USA last year, played at Eastmore Academy powerhouse in Ohio high school basketball. That time, just a little bit awkward with the pass. RedHawks back on offense. Here's Larry, pulls up from the far elbow and knocks it down. A long delay before the RedHawks' first points finally get him 3.5 minutes in. Makai Larry makes it 5-2. To the near wing, Kinsey puts it down through the lane, a skyhook from Taylor off the glass and in. Andrew Taylor with 4 of Marshall's 7 points here early on. Light pressure applied as Makai Larry makes his way across the timeline. He's fouled as he raced down the right lane, and he will inbound from the baseline. Fast-paced opening few minutes, Zach, and filled with errors, it seems, on both sides. Couple turnovers, some block shots that the RedHawks had not had go their way either.
Yeah, and this is shades of that early in that Goshen game where they're just giving the ball back and forth, back and forth. Luckily, they aren't digging themselves a hole, but they got to figure it out on the offensive end.
Three ball from Mabry is too strong, bounced up and hit the top of the backboard. Ryan Mabry, he's a three-point shooter. That was his game when he was in high school at a La Lumiere High School in Indianapolis, but only shooting around 21% from beyond the arc. Quickly up the floor, a sky shot is good for Taylor. Nobody touched him as he made his way all the way into the paint. And an easy bucket there for Marshall, who now lead 9-2. 15:47 to go here in the first half. Larry with a delayed jumper. That one won't go. Rebounded by Marshall here. They come the other way. Kinsey tried to go at it with one hand, and a foul is called on the RedHawks. Kinsey going for the one-handed flush. He couldn't get it to fall, but he will head to the line.
Yeah, and a little bit of an odd look there. We don't have the best angle, but from our angle, it kind of looked like Mabry got all ball there, and I think that was the reaction of the Miami bench. Obviously, we got to consider our source with their reaction, but it certainly looked like a great attempt by Mabry to dislodge that. Did his job. He'll get whistled for the foul, but nonetheless, you take out that easy two for Marshall.
So some free throws on the way for the leading scorer for Marshall, Tavion Kinsey, when we return. Miami basketball here on Red Hawk Radio. Back to Millett Hall in just a moment. Stay with us. .15:38 to go here in the first half. 9-2 Thundering Herd on the road. Marshall has jumped on Miami. And a couple of free throws on the way for Tavion Kinsey, 6'5", 50-year guard out of Columbus.
Yeah, Luke, he scored 19 points per game last week, and he's up to 25.5 points per game this year. Guy can absolutely find nylon at any point in the game.
75% free throw shooter, can't find the first one. Leading scorer the last two seasons for the Thundering Herd. Staying for that fifth year. Second shot on the way, and he'll knock it down. Marshall into double digits, 10-2 our score, 15:37 now here to go in the first half. Mekhi Larry carries across the timeline. Larry directs traffic. Sends it up top for Jaquel Morris. Morris slips it down low. Lewis sends one outside. Kick to the top of the key. Now Yofin going to drive down the lane. Up and under. That one hits off the bottom of the rim. Passing attempt is blocked as Jaquel Morris tried to kick it outside. And now the Herd move it up the court quickly. Into the corner. Thinking about the shot was Kirkman. Instead, he'll send it back outside. Gets it back along the upper wing. Sends a shot in, and that one will not go. Tipped around. And out the baseline. Last touch from Miami. It'll be Marshall Ball. 20 on the shot clock, 15:03 to go.
Yeah, and although Lewis was unable to corral that great box out, obviously undersized against Anochilikilin, and it didn't show too bad there. Was able to knock it around and just kind of hit off his leg going out of bounds.
Drive and a pull-up there is good. Knocking it down is Andrew Taylor, who's got 8 points in the game now with Marshall in front by 10.
Luke, he's a bucket getter. No matter where he is on the floor, it just seems like he's always a threat to score no matter what the shot is, and he just finds a way to make shots.
Here's a mid-range pull-up that rolls around the rim and goes in for Julian Lewis. Miami with their first sign of offensive life in a couple of minutes. Past the five-minute mark now, 14:25 and counting here to go in half number one. From the near wing, Taylor bounces it into the corner. Kinsey back out to Taylor, deep three, and that one off the mark, rebounded for Miami by Lewis, who leapt up to grab that one. Lewis will carry across the timeline. He's got a top of the key, going to take a semi-contested three, too strong. Rebound is double-teamed by Marshall. They'll get it. Andrew Taylor with the board. Taylor runs off the screen, top of the key, lost the ball, regained it, found a wide open Anna Chili killing at the top of the key. Three ball is no good. Rebound tipped around and picked up by Miami's Jaquel Morris. Now Yofin across the timeline. Yofin, the walk-on, he's been fantastic for Miami through the early goings of this season, gives to Larry. Now Morris at the free throw line, slip one down low to Larry, who puts it in and one. Really nice cut there from Makai Larry to the basket, undersized at 5'8", was double teamed as well, but he gets it to go with the left hand. And the RedHawks with the first big momentum swinger here with 13:40 to go in the first half.
Yeah, and Luke, credit to Jaquel Morris on that play. I love when he's on the floor. I think Miami, through the early goings of the season, are at their best when 21 finds himself in the lineup in some form or fashion. He just brings an edge in the rebounding game. It's nothing against Marambo. It just seems like he's got a better vertical. He's able to contest more. Being from Queens, obviously, he's a grinder and made a great pass there to Larry. He converts like he does at the line, and I just love what 21 brings to the lineup.
Makai Larry stays perfect on the season at the free throw line, like Zach mentioned, and continues to not hit the rim either. Marshall back on offense, up by five. Tripping there was Kinsey, got it back near the free throw line. Now top of the key, Taylor trying to go to work, finds Kinsey, backdoor cut, and the pass is over the intended target in Hedlington and out of bounds.
And guess whose hand was in the passing lane? Jaquel Morris. It just seems like this guy has a knack for being at the right spot at the right time, disrupting things on the defensive end and making plays on the offensive end.
Miami in a five-point hole, 12-7 our score. Larry going to try to cut into it with a left wing three. That one no good. And a foul called on the rebound. Look out. Jaquel Morris was very, very frustrated after he got tied up there with Micah Hedlington. Had to be careful there, was very close to the referee, but was able to calm himself down on his own, which is, of course, good. And it'll just be a Marshall inbound and carrying across the timeline, Camden Kerfman. Hedlington to the far wing where Connor found it. Now a mid-range look opens up, and it's off the iron and no good for Taylor. Rebounded for Miami by Billy Smith. The Indianapolis native hands it off to Bryson Tatum, who's freshly checked into the game. Tatum hands off to Jaquel Morris. Now Larry near the logo with the jab step. Larry around the screen to the left side through the left lane. High off the glass, and that one won't go for him. Kerfman picks it up in stride. Hands off on the far side to Connor underneath. He got blocked but fouled. Jacob Connor, Dayton, Ohio native, product of Alter High School, will head to the line. And the true freshman will look to knock down his first free throws of the season with Marshall up by five. Jacob Connor, the big 6'8 guard forward hybrid, hits the first one. Connor, a guy that was offered by Miami, also Northern Kentucky, Ohio, Toledo, many other programs in the area, very highly touted recruit, ended up going with the herd, taking his talents to Marshall. And now back here in Oxford, just about an hour south of his hometown of Dayton. Second free throw is up, rolls around the rim, and rebounded by Miami's Eli Yofin. Yofin skies a pass near half court where Larry got to it. Larry now on the far wing, bounces one in. Marambo trying to go to work. Marambo bashing into the paint, faked the shot, got around it and put it in. Anderson Marambo, flight of foot. A really nice athletic play to cut it to one possession. 13-10, Marshall, 12:05 to go. Right in front of the Miami bench, tip pass by Yofin, up in the air. Tatum climbs the ladder and gets to it. Still tipped around, saved by Miami's Makai Larry, who goes over the scorer's table. Now Yofin into the near wing, three ball from Tatum is good. Unreal. Makai Larry jumps back over the scorer's table. He's back into the game, and the RedHawks have tied it at 13 aside.
all effort right now, Luke, and they are making plays all over the floor.
And a three on the other side by Wyatt Fricks. Wyatt Fricks puts Marshall back in front by three. That'll calm down the Millett Hall crowd just a little bit after a wild sequence. As of right now, they've only got 2 points up on the board for Tatum's shot. May have had his foot on the line. I imagine it'll get reviewed at the break. Right now, Miami's got it on the far wing, and now a mid-range shot from Marambo rattles around it in. Anderson Marambo finally getting into this game. A guy that was so successful on opening night, struggled a little bit in the game against Georgia on Monday.
Yeah, and he's big right now, Luke, and he's a streaky player. He's just got to get hot, and it seems like he's finally finding that touch.
Mid-range shot way off balance, and it's no good for Kinsey. Rebounded for Miami by Yofin. Yofin races across the timeline. Now he'll pull it back and settle down. Tatum's got it for the RedHawks. Tatum sends it to Marambo. Marambo floats to the far side of the court, hands off to Yofin. Thought about the deep two, reach in foul is called on Kinsey as Yofin attempted the drive. And the RedHawks will inbound after the fourth team foul from the Thundering Herd following this media timeout. 10:30 to go, and some life has been injected into Millett Hall. Miami trailing by two, 16-14 your score. Back in a moment from Oxford, and this is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. To go here in half number one. Luke West, boys, Zach Rangers alongside. Marshall leading Miami 16-14. RedHawks with a chance to take their first lead. Like in that opening night game, Zach, we saw the RedHawks get off to a bit of a sluggish start. They've done a nice job, though, to claw their way back into this one.
Yeah, Luke, and they're giving 115% right now all across the floor. We see Makai Larry jumping over the scorer's table. It just seems like the RedHawks have got it going in waves right now, and momentum is at an all-time high.
Out of the inbound, Marambo turns it around, drives into the paint. Marambo from the MAC logo tries to thread the pass down the baseline. Found the target, but the attempt put up by Tatum is blocked. He went down on the court to try and get to the rebound as the ball was rolling around. It'll be called for a foul as he chopped the legs out from underneath of Wyatt Fricks. Fourth team foul for Miami, first for Bryson Tatum. And the RedHawks can't cash in. And the lead remains with Marshall. Taylor drives down the lane, kicks out, open three in the corner, knocked down, Wyatt Fricks. 2 for 2 from beyond the arc for number two in black, and Marshall has extended the lead to 5. 19-14, under 10 minutes to go here in half number one. Larry from the top of the key gets a screen from Marambo. Larry turns it back out for Marambo, top of the key three, and he puts it in. Marambo unafraid to shoot that shot. Travis Steele said if it's a good shot, he'll take it any day as to Marambo shooting threes. And Miami back down by just two. McKenzie over to the wing, contested three from Fricks, and he puts it home. Wyatt Fricks, who was shooting just 25% from three-point range this season coming into this game, is now 3-for-3 from beyond the arc. He's hot, and Marshall back in front by five. Larry on the far wing takes a contested three of his own. This one is well short off the front rim, rebounded for Marshall by Kinsey. Tavion Kinsey races forward into the corner, thinking about the shot there was Connor. Instead, he sends it onto the far wing for Fricks, who hands off to Taylor back towards the middle. Under 20 to shoot. Taylor gets it back. Taylor driving in, takes a long two, and that one is in and out. Rebounded for Miami by Lewis. Lewis slows up right at the three-point line, backs out and hands off to Marambo, who takes another three, and that one off the rim, and it is no good. Rebounded by Connor for Marshall. They're going to try to go quick up the court. Toussaint couldn't get the shot off down low. Kick back outside. Right wing three is good for Taylor. The Herd are hot from beyond the arc right now. Marshall 5-for-9 from deep. And they lead by 8 now, 25-17. This is a Marshall team that was shooting 34% from three-point range this season. Now a three in Miami's own from Tatum. That one too strong. Rebound comes all the way back outside. Yofin gives it a try from three, and he knocks it down. Taylor made there for Eli Yofin. Rebound kicked right out to him on the left wing. And with nobody in front of him, Eli Yofin puts it in for his first points. Now for Marshall. This is Kinsey on the near side. Kinsey got around a screen. It was done illegally. Offensive foul is called. Emmerich Toussaint, the native of St. Denis, Reunion Island, called for the foul, and we will get a timeout on the floor with 25-20. Our score, Marshall in front, 7:43 to go here in half number one. We return in a moment from Oxford. Stay with us, Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. .743 to go in what has quickly turned into a track meet between Miami and Marshall. Herd on top 25-20, and Zach, both teams just shooting the ball, it seems, at first chance. Marshall knocking their shots down right now, 5-for-9 from deep and 56% from the floor.
Yeah, and having Fricks on their squad for Marshall is big right now. 3-for-3 from the three ball range, and Wyatt Fricks has had it going from deep. Luckily, Miami has been able to keep up with them, Luke. This is where we've seen usually this year Miami will fall behind teams, is when we see the opposition shooting well. That's kind of when we see Miami kind of run into some mud and they can't really get past it. But right now they're staying with them. We saw Yofin hit that big three right before the break. They're right in this game, 25-20. This is going to be a good one going down the stretch. I can feel it.
Absolutely. And a big selling point for Travis Steele to his team was that compete level. It's safe to say it's been very, very high here tonight. Seen some really high effort from the RedHawks. And this is just something that is very, very new with Travis Steele. You look at Miami teams from years past and you don't see some of the stuff that you're seeing now. Guys diving all over the floor for loose balls. You see Makai Larry go over the scorer's table. Just crazy, crazy stuff. They are selling out. Miami looking for their first D1 win of the season. 1-2 on the year, with the only victory coming against NAIA opponent Goshen. Out of the timeout, it's Red Hawk ball, 25-20, they trail. Billy Smith has it from the logo. Smith tosses over for Jaquel Morris. Morris to the near side. Lewis drives to the basket. His arm got hit when he put that Ball towards the outside, and it's taken away by the Thundering Herd. Here comes Taylor down the lane. He hands off on the baseline, turned back outside in the corner for Taylor. Now a logo three taken by Kerfman. That one off the iron, and it's rebounded for Miami by Bryson Tatum. He was making those in warm-ups, but that time it's not going to go for Kerfman. Now Yofin, or rather Mabry, in the corner for Miami, up top for Billy Smith. Smith, top of the key, hands it down at the free throw line. Jaquel Morris hands to Mabry. Mabry on the drive, lost it as he tried to head down the lane. Lead pass up ahead for Connor. He secures it and throws it down with two hands. Bryson Tatum did his best to get the steal, try to secure the loose ball, but Connor beat him one-on-one. And the Dayton native makes it 27-20. Marshall with 6:33 to go here in the first half. Lewis, top of the key for Morris. Lewis got it back at the free throw line. Triple team sends it into the corner. Smith takes a long two and he hits.
With a hand in his face as well, Luke. That was a nice shot by Billy Smith.
First shot of the game, first make for Billy Smith. Into the corner, quick shot is too strong for Marshall, and on the rebound, a foul called on Miami. Put back attempt from Emmerich Toussaint was too strong, but he got a hand in the back going up for that board. Foul will be on Jaquel Morris, and that is his third foul. Miami's fifth. Emmerich Toussaint will head to the line. Toussaint puts the first one in.
Yeah,
it's his
not
first make of the season.
Not what you were looking for if you're Miami. You put Jaquel Morris back in, and your only real advice to him is don't pick up another foul before halftime, and does just that, only being in for about a minute. It's going to be a long time on the bench for Morris before he gets back in this one.
6:11 to go, and the second shot is nowhere close, wide right. Mabry up ahead for Miami down the far side. Tatum going to drive. Tatum turns around. Back outside. Mitchell Riley out for Billy Smith. Smith drove in, now passes back out top of the key. Fake shot for Lewis. He drives down, was triple covered, threaded the needle, and drew a foul. Julian Lewis, the Ann Arbor native, and William and Mary transfer, will draw the foul and head to the line. The foul will be on Obina and Achille Killen, or Marshall. 16 foul for Marshall. Julian Lewis will shoot two. And the William & Mary transfer gets the roll on the first one. He was a guy that Travis Steele had a lot of praise for in the press conference. He's only played two of the three games, missed the season opener, did Julian Lewis for the RedHawks, but a real spark plug, especially thinking about the subtraction of Morgan Safford, who was great for Miami before that injury in the opening game against Evansville. Julian Lewis knocks the second one down, and now the lead is back down to four. He's kind of hung around that area for most of the night. Taylor's got it offensively for Marshall. Gets a screen top of the key, sends to the far wing. Fricks on the three, and it's another for Wyatt Fricks. 4 for 4 from the field, and he's going to be called for a foul on the way back. I believe he got a technical foul. Yeah, he was pointing at his own bench.
A technical foul has been called on.
And Wyatt Fricks just getting a little overzealous there, a guy who averaged only 7 points per game coming into tonight. He already has 12. He's 4 for 4 from three. But just getting a little bit too mouthy. Free throws will be shot for Miami by Billy Smith. He'll miss the first. President Greg Crawford picks it up here at courtside. Hands it back to the official. RedHawks now in the bonus. And Smith will knock the second one down. Seems to be some general understanding now between the official and Wyatt Fricks. Or rather, that was Micah Handlington, who may have been apologetic for his teammates' behavior during that break. RedHawks will be on offense now, down by 6 following the technical foul to Wyatt Fricks. Riley sends it into the post, driving baseline. It's kicked to the near corner for Smith. An open three is way too strong. Airballed over the basket and picked up by David Early for Marshall. Early making his first appearance. Sends it into the corner. Wide open three, but an offensive foul opened that lane up. And the RedHawks will get the ball. And inbound, 5:10 to go. Miami trailing by 6.
And Luke, what are the Catholic schools around the Cincinnati and Covington area do really well? Take charges. Mitchell Riley, Covington Catholic grad, no question on that one. who has taken that charge. That's what they preach around that Cincinnati area. I really don't know why, but they live, breathe, and die by taking charges, and that's an energizer play on defense.
Riley, top player in Region 9 in Kentucky, had the ball for a moment and handed it off to Mabry. Now he's got it back in the post. Here's Riley spinning around in the paint. Shot is too strong, went up for the rebound, but instead it's found first by Kerfman for Marshall. Kerfman skies one up ahead, waiting on it, and a nice hesitation from Anacili Killen. He puts it off the glass and in. And now a quick steal for the Thundering Herd, sent back out to half court. Anacili Killen leaps up for it into the corner. A three ball is knocked in by Kerfman. Kerfman forced the steal on a lackadaisical inbound for Miami. Eventually got the ball back after sending it back out to half court. And he hit the three. The Maryland native and VMI transfer has put Marshall back in front by double digits. 36-25 is our score. Timeout called by the RedHawks with 4:30 to go. Travis Steele wants to talk it over. His team with a couple of bad possessions strung together. Lead back out to double digits. Back here from Millett Hall momentarily. This is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio.
Gear
36-25, Thundering Herd over RedHawks. 4:30 to go here in half number one. Luke West, Poley, Zach Rengers alongside here from Millett Hall. Marshall has opened up this lead thanks to some really good shooting from the floor. Thundering Herd 59.1% on field goals, 54% from three. And they've hit some really contested looks so far in this one as well. RedHawks looking to put this lead back into single digits. It's gotten as low as one possession, but the RedHawks have not led. Larry over for Mabry. Mabry sends it into the lane. Riley lost it. Picked up for Marshall by Hanlington, and Hanlington just sent it into the Herd bench as he was trying to regroup with Taylor. Miami catches a break as they were racing back defensively. And with 4:12 to go, the RedHawks will get the ball back.
Yeah, and Luke, this is a RedHawk team that looked out of sorts without Larry on the floor back a few minutes ago. Look for them to get back in that rhythm, having the true point guard ball handler bring it up for them. Look for them to find a rhythm yet again.
Nine players have seen the floor for Miami here in the first half. Larry's got it top of the key, 10 to shoot. Larry backing up, now racing to the baseline. Larry with a beautiful kick out to the wing. Open three from Billy Smith won't go. Rebounded by Marambo. He's got three black jerseys around him and still able to draw the foul. Really, really nice job there by Anderson Marambo. The Dominican, averaging 15 points per game, fueled mostly by a Herculean effort on night one. We'll head to the line now for the RedHawks. And Marambo swishes the first one. Pretty good free throw shooter for a big man. 84.6% on the season. RedHawks are 84% as a team. They were the best in the MAC last year in free throw percentage as well. Second one is good for Anderson Marambo. RedHawks now 6-for-7 as a team from the line tonight. The only miss came from Billy Smith after the technical foul. And stepping on the sideline there as they tried to head up the court as Andrew Taylor got the ball handed off to him by David Early. And now the Herd with a couple of mental mistakes. Lead is down to 9. RedHawks with the ball across half court. This is Makai Larry. Larry to the near wing. Bounces it into the post. Marambo bashing his way forward. Skyhook is too far to the left. Rebounded for Marshall by Handlington. Quickly into the corner. Now back out to the wing and top of the key. A logo three taken by Kerfman, and he connects. No hesitation on that shot from Camden Kerfman early in the shot clock. And now the RedHawks struggling to inbound this basketball. Billy Smith finally just puts it in, and luckily for the RedHawks, Julian Lewis is there. Now quickly up the court. Smith fakes the three, gets his defender by him, sends it up, and that one is no good. Rebounded offensively by Marambo, ducks underneath and puts it in. 11 points now for Anderson Marambo. He's Miami's leading scorer. Another quick transition three by Kerfman is good. Marshall continues to light it up from beyond the arc. Herd providing some pressure. Mabry turns it over under the basket. A falling shot is over the top by Taylor, and Mabry will draw the foul as he was trying to carry it back up the court. So Ryan Mabry catches a bit of a break there, and then on the second try is able to draw the foul. Miami will shoot with the bonus. It'll be a 1-1 for Ryan Mabry as he looks to pick up his first points of the evening. RedHawks will huddle up here in the backcourt, trailing by 13, 42-29 with 2:37 to go here in half number one.
Yeah, and Luke, we've seen Anderson Marambo. He's undersized, which is hard to believe, but he is right now still gutting out so many rebounds. Right now, we mentioned he's good from the line. This guy's really just an anomaly. I mean, we're looking at, you see Anderson Marambo, you think football player all the way, over 300 pounds, 6'8", and then he comes out on the floor and he is just money from all these different spots. You gotta love what you're seeing from 45, and he's really kept Miami in it in the second half, in his first half.
Mabry hits both, and the lead is down to 11. Mabry, the only Miami player in double figures right now in points. Second highest scores, Makai Larry with 5. Or Marambo, I should say. Deep three taken again early in the shot clock. This time it's no good for Fricks. His first miss. Rebound, though, is collected by Taylor, and he cleans up the loose change. Untimely offensive rebound there for the RedHawks as the lead balloons back out to 13. 2:07 to go here in the first half. Larry sends it down to the high post. Marambo sends it back outside for Yofin. Now back outside for Marambo. Marambo puts it up top for Smith. Smith waves it to the far side. Yofin driving up the left lane, puts up an up and under ball that is tipped around on the rebound and sent out of bounds off the hands of a Marshall player underneath the basket. It'll be Miami basketball. 1:47 to go, RedHawks down by 13. Larry quickly inbounds it to Marambo. Marambo down to the basket, lost it on the ground and into the Marshall bench. It'll be Miami ball. Marshall player right there, let it go. That was Andrew Taylor. He thought his team was gonna get it, wanted the inbound instead of just picking the ball up and going the other way, and it will not pay off for him. RedHawks are gonna get this back with 14 to shoot in front of the Marshall bench. Inbounded out to half court where Makai Larry is there. 1:37 to go, under 10 to shoot. Larry up the left lane, gets some separation, kicks into the corner. Smith fakes the three, steps back, now hands back to Larry. Contested shot with 1 on the shot clock, will not hit the rim, and it's a violation for Miami. Smith faked the shot, thought he was gonna get more separation than he did, and then it was just a football backfield, so to speak, with guys handing it back and forth. And the RedHawks couldn't get up a good shot. With 1:27 to go, they'll turn it back over to Marshall. 44-31 with 1:23 to go now. Clock moving. Taylor tries to drive, now pulls back. Taylor had it stripped away by Larry. Picked up by Yofin, he hands it back to Larry. Larry to Yofin on the far wing. Three ball, line driver. No, rattles away. Rebounded by Andrew Taylor. Taylor to the far wing for Connor. Cross court pass to the near corner. Kerfman thought about the three, instead he heads back out to half court. Under a minute to play, 54 seconds remaining here in the first half. In the high post, back outside the arc for Fricks. Fricks tried to thread one underneath, tipped away by Miami's Tatum, picked up by Marambo. Tatum's got it back now across half court. Tatum faking, spinning down the lane, still waiting on an opening. Instead, it'll be kicked all the way around to the near corner. Three ball rolls away for Eli Yofin. Rebound to the far side, diving on the court unnecessarily there was Hanlington. Thought he had a guy on his back, did not. Marshall had more time. Shot clock remains on, separated from the game clock by 3 seconds. With the Thundering Herd on offense, they're going to use the use it or lose it timeout. 22.7 seconds remain. They'll have 22 shoot coming out of this 30-second timeout. And Zach, it's been a theme for the RedHawks throughout these first few games that just at unfortunate times, it seems like the other team gets hot. Marshall has done really well from the floor here in this first half. You played pretty solid. Of course, there were some areas of your game where, of course, you'd like to work on, but with 22.7 seconds left for Miami, you probably feel like you played a little better than a 13-point deficit would show.
Yeah, and that's what you get when you have a team that on the other side is shooting 56% from three. I mean, video game numbers right now from this Marshall team. It just seems like whenever they get any bit of separation on the offensive end, they're at will to shoot, and that's what they've done tonight. Now, with that being said, Miami, I think they can obviously agree that their offensive attack has been less than impressive at times tonight. They've settled for bad shots at times. We've seen guys just not really get fully in their groove from beyond the arc for the RedHawks, and they're going to look to do that coming out of this break. That's going to be this halftime, and look to get a turnover here. We see Jaquel Morris back on the floor. They're going to look to get a turnover and then get a bucket before halftime.
Shot and game clock once again separated by about 3 seconds. 16 seconds to go. Ball is tipped away by Eli Yofin. He's been a specialist in that category. Andrew Taylor regains, and Taylor is fouled by Yofin. But 6 on the shot clock. Yofin with the reach in just slapped the front number there of Taylor. And unfortunately there for the RedHawks, that means no more possession. Shot clock will turn off with 9 seconds to go. And Marshall will inbound with a chance for the final shot. Official has to instruct longtime head coach Dan DeAntoni to back up into his box. But now Marshall will inbound. RedHawks giving him a tough time. This one just floated into the backcourt, secured by Kerfman. 6 to go. Kerfman with Yofin on him just pulls up with an off-balance look, got fouled. Clock continued to run. There's going to be a few seconds at least put up on it, I'd imagine. Travis Steele frustrated with the foul call. There's 0.9 seconds remaining. I'd be very surprised if they don't reset this clock. That foul was called with about 3 seconds left, it looked like. Clock continued to run. First free throw is good from Kerfman. And it looks like we're sticking with 0.9, so 14-point lead for Marshall, a chance to make it 15 right before the break. Miami's going to bring in Mirambo if that matters, and it won't as the shot is missed. Last-ditch heave is no good for Miami's Julian Lewis. And that'll be it for 20 minutes of play here from Oxford. We kind of alluded to it just before that final sequence, Zach, but overall a less than impressive result for the RedHawks after feeling like they played a pretty solid first half, especially effort-wise, but at the end of the day, it is the results that really matter. Miami finds themselves in a pretty good-sized hole here at the break.
Yeah, and great effort. Like you said, Luke, on the first half, we saw RedHawks diving all around the floor. They were getting 50-50 balls. Everything looked like it should have been falling into place, but you're absolutely right. A 14-point deficit going into halftime, you don't feel like you deserved it, but at the end of the day, it's something that they're going to have to deal with, because when you're playing a team that's shooting 60% from field goal and 56 from three-point land, you're not going to be in that game. You got to find a way to close out better, get altered shots for Marshall, and just get back to your attack on offense. They've struggled doing that to this point in the game, and they're going to need to figure it out going down the stretch in this one.
Marshall out shooting Miami 59% from the field, 56% from three. RedHawks 29% from the field, 17% from three. Miami is on the plus side in turnovers, 8 for the RedHawks in the first half, 11 for Marshall, in an area that Dan DeAntoni is going to want to clean up moving forward into the second half. But regardless, his team here on the road against a former conference rival is holding on to a 14-point lead and got to be very happy with how things have gone for the Thundering Herd through the opening 20 minutes. We'll take a break. We'll be back with the second half of play in just a bit. Stay with us. Miami trailing, and this is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. at the halftime break here from Millett Hall, 45-31, our score, with the Marshall Thundering Herd leading the Miami RedHawks. Luke West, Poley, Zach Ringers alongside here on RedHawk Radio. Leading scores for Marshall in the opening frame, Andrew Taylor and Camden Kerfman both with 13. Of course, the highlight, though, was Wyatt Fricks, the big 6'8 forward, going 4 for his first 4. He was eventually 4 for 5 from 3 on a route to 12 points for Miami. Anderson Marambo, the only man in double digits for the RedHawks. 11 points for Anderson. Second highest score for Miami, Makai Larry with 5, followed closely by Julian Lewis with 4. Zach, effort-wise, we talked about it before the break. Miami's right there. You could argue maybe even out-competing Marshall right now, but not making their shots, and they find themselves down in a pretty solid hole after 20 minutes of play.
Yeah, and they're going to have to get the offensive end going right now, Luke, and this is pretty much on par with the cores for Miami. They've struggled to get the offense going early. Luckily, in a lot of their games recently, they've been able to put it together in the second half and make runs. They're going to need a run like they had against that Goshen team about a week ago. They're going to need a run like that if they want to get back in this game against Marshall. But nonetheless, it just feels like you can really chalk it up as great shooting for Marshall, poor shooting for Miami. You start leveling that playing field out a little bit, it feels like Miami will be right back in this game.
Heard 59% from the field, 56%, 9 for 16. From beyond the arc, Miami 3 for 17 from 3 for 17.6%, 10 for 34 from the floor for 29.4%. Old rivalry between these two teams. First time that Marshall has played the RedHawks since 2005. Long time ago. This is the first of 4 MAC games that Marshall has in non-conference. They will also have Akron, OU, and Toledo on the schedule. Toledo, the final team on that schedule, going to be a really, really tough matchup for this Marshall team. Little Fun Belt MAC action here on a Thursday night. Marshall leaving Conference USA last year, getting set for their first Sun Belt basketball season after a less than impressive season last year in their final year in Conference USA. 12-21 overall, 4-14 in conference was Dan D'Antoni's team. Have not made the tournament since 2018, but when they were there, they upset fourth seeded Wichita State in the first round. D'Antoni, a guy that brings a lot of experience. His brother, of course, was an NBA head coach. He was an NBA assistant coach for 3 different teams. He's put together a nice staff as well, a couple of alums from Marshall on his staff as assistants. He himself is a Marshall alum, one of the best guards to ever don the uniform for the Thundering Herd. Graduated way back in 1970 and is inducted in the Marshall Thundering Herd Hall of Fame as well. So 45-31, crowd is still really, really solid. They were getting riled up during the break. Expect them to be very loud. Rowdy after what was an energetic affair through the opening 20 minutes. RedHawks in their final home game for a little while. They won't be back here at Millett Hall for about a week and a half. Next Saturday afternoon, they will take on Little Rock. But the big matchup circled on everybody's calendar, including ours, Zach, as you and I will be there at Gainbridge Fieldhouse. The RedHawks will head to Indianapolis on Sunday to take on the 12th-ranked Hoosiers from Indiana. IU off tonight. They will have one game in between now and then as they head to Cintas tomorrow to take on the Xavier Musketeers in what should be a really, really good one and a fun test for Sean Miller's team. Both of those teams undefeated. Back underway here in our second half from Oxford. Miami with first possession in the 14-point hole. Anderson Marambo controlling on the far wing. Kind of wincing as he made his way inside. But Marambo still doing his thing in the post, got up and under, found space and put it right in. Easy bucket there for Anderson Marambo, but really nice job to set it up. And the RedHawks find the scoreboard just about 20 seconds in here to half number 2. For Marshall, Kerfman sends to the far side. Up the wing, Kinsey pulls up from mid-range and hits. Kinsey, a guy that is needing to get going for Marshall in this game. Only 1 point through the opening half for a guy who averages nearly 26 on the season, Marshall's leading scorer. For Miami down the lane is Lewis. He'll draw a foul. So he headed up the left side.
And Luke, right now we see Marambo for Miami. He looks a little shaken up, and I think he's getting taken off the floor for Jaquel Morris, and this is a gamble for Travis Steele because obviously Jaquel Morris had three fouls early in that first half. They're going to need him to stay out of foul trouble if they can help him out. Talking about Marambo down low.
Quick lane opens up, and it's finished off by Billy Smith. Smith with the quick bucket off the inbound. Marambo has headed back to the tunnel. Taylor, skyhook rolling around, finds its way in. Andrew Taylor, second leading scorer for Marshall this season, having a nice night for himself. 15 points now, leads the herd in sole possession of that first place mark in the game. For Miami on three fouls is Jaquel Morris, out to the top of the key for Billy Smith. Smith drives, now pulls back. Lewis surveys from the top of the key. One hands it on in, at the elbow, Morris with his back turned, seven to shoot. Floats it to the far corner for Lewis. Lewis pulls up from mid-range after a bit of a drive. That one off the inside of the rim and back out, rebounded by Handlington for Marshall. Heard quickly up the floor. Taylor lost it on the drive, kicked it up ahead down the baseline, and it will be Miami ball. Saw that at times from Marshall. They're not a team that really tries to push the pace 100% of the time, but they can certainly play with speed. Billy Smith again struggling to inbound the ball, and Miami's going to have to take a timeout. And Travis Steele with some expletives as they head into the huddle. He's not happy bringing them into the huddle here with 18-19 to go. 49-35 with Miami inbounding. And Travis Steele talked about in his press conference earlier this week, because of the lack of depth this team has due to injury, due to eligibility issues. You look down the lineup, there's no Javen Etzler for Miami, no Kamari Williams due to eligibility issues, no Curtis Harrison due to injury, and of course no Morgan Safford due to injury. He said that preseason you would have liked to see this team play with a lot of speed. That was the game they wanted to play. They were a shooting team that liked to get up the floor and play pretty fast, but he said now he's content to have his team pull back and slow down that pace just a little bit if they need to due to the lack of depth they have and that short bench because of injury. Javen Etzler and Curtis Harrison, guys who have been solid for Miami, both played around 25 games. Harrison has played 23 in his career, and Javen Etzler 28 for the RedHawks. Neither guys appear in a game this season, though, as they both had surgeries. Travis Steele hoping to get both of them back around conference time. For Morgan Safford, man, he was a real spark plug for the RedHawks, and really hated to see him go down after how good he was in the opening 30 minutes of that Evansville game. Went down with an apparent knee injury, but Travis Steele did not shy away from saying the RedHawks dodged a bullet. He's going to be out for about a month, but anytime a guy goes down holding the knee, you got to be thankful that he's not out for the year. So good for the RedHawks that they will likely get Morgan Safford back in just a few weeks. And of course, still dealing with some administration issues, dealing with the NCAA as to the eligibility of Kamari Williams, the Boston College transfer who averaged 6 points per game last season for the RedHawks. Really came alive towards the tail end of last year, averaged 11.4 points per game. Travis Steele talked about how good of an offseason he had. Obviously, he finished the last season well, thought he was carrying a ton of momentum into this year. Really just unfortunate for the RedHawks that Kamari Williams could not be in the lineup to start things off. But Steele said they're not going to make excuses for the team.
Yeah, and Luke, you look up and down the floor, and that's exactly what I was going to talk about. You hate to make excuses, but you look at who they're missing, it's very significant. They're missing a lot of size, a lot of guys that can stretch the floor like Safford, like Williams. Obviously, Kamari Williams, not having him is huge. 6'7" forward, and he can shoot the ball well, and just not having him is monumental for this team, and they just need to get healthy before MAC play because this can really be a dangerous team when they're at full strength.
49-35 out of the timeout, Red Hawk ball, 18:06 to go. Trying to send that one into the paint there was Lewis. His pass was blocked by Kinsey, who's got the ball now in his hands. Kinsey calls for a screen. Kinsey goes the other way, up the lane, lifts it up and finishes. There's the offensive firepower we know from Tavion Kinsey. Only 5 points for him in the game. For the RedHawks, going down in the paint was Billy Smith. The ball careened over though to Ryan Mabry, who picked it up in the left corner. Mirambeau got it on the top of the key, tried to send it inside, and the ball was kicked, I believe, or rather now they're going to call a foul underneath the basket. And the RedHawks will inbound. 17:31 to go, and this lead has grown by two since the halftime break. 51-35, Marshall on top. Larry inbounding under the basket, tried to go to the player underneath. That was Smith. They got that play earlier on. This time, though, they'll send to the corner where Mabry had it. Just sent a pass into a tight space, and Mirambeau couldn't secure it. Luckily, though, for the RedHawks, a foul will be called. And the foul for Marshall will be on Micah Hedlington. That'll be his first, second team foul for the Herd. Miami going to inbound in the same spot as last time underneath the basket. Larry looking for an option, finds Smith in the corner, takes the three. Too strong. Lifting up is Taylor for the rebound. Taylor quickly across half court, finds Connor down the lane, slam it home. Jacob Connor having a field day near his hometown. Couple of dunks in this one. Marshall on top by 18. Larry up top for Mirambeau, top of the key. Now to the far wing for Lewis. Lewis back to Larry. Larry guarding the basketball, gets around the screen. Larry tries to thread through, and a foul will be called on Marshall as he made his way to the basket. Foul will be on Camden Kerfman. He will take his third. Ryan Mabry comes out for the RedHawks. In comes Eli Yofin for Marshall. They will bring in Wyatt Fricks, and he will replace Camden Kerfman. Miami inbounding now from the right side of the basket. On the baseline, this is Larry. Sends an outside pass to Mirambeau, who hands it right back to him. Larry, double covered on the near side, just sends it out top of the key. Now on the far wing, this is Smith, tried to send it back half court, and that one too far away from Makai Larry. It'll be Marshall ball, as that one found its way into the Marshall broadcast booth. And the Thundering Herd with a chance to make it 20 on this possession. 53-35 with 16:38 to go. Kinsey gives it to Hedlington. Now Taylor takes it from the free throw line. Jumper rattles away, no good. Rebounded by Mirambeau for the RedHawks. Miami with a quick move up the floor. Really good pass, but it is blocked at the rim by Tatum. Or from Tatum, I should say, by Connor. Here comes Marshall. Fricks puts it up, no good. Put back attempt, rolls away, and rebounded by Miami's Anderson Mirambeau. Really good pass in that last play by Makai Larry, but Tatum couldn't get the finish at the rim. Larry's got it now. He will thread his way forward. Larry gets to the baseline, eventually kicked all the way around. Fake shot by Tatum. He drives, fades now in the mid-range, and that one goes in and out. Rebounded for Marshall by Hedlington. Now Taylor across half court. Taylor skies one up for the alley-oop. That one away from the intended target, and Kinsey flew into the Miami band. And the Herd will turn it over, but RedHawks having a tough, tough time right now. This lead has been expanded quite a bit. 18 points now, Marshall on top, 53-35 with 15:49 to go here in the second half. We'll return to Millett Hall in just a moment. RedHawks in need of something in terms of energy. We'll be back from Oxford. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. When the sun goes down, sleepless nights you wake me up when the sun goes down. I can't help it, baby, not myself when the sun goes down. I can't stop, baby. Down, 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 down 4:11 gone by here in the second half. Marshall on top by 18, 53-35 over Miami here at Millett Hall on a Thursday night in Oxford. Some non-conference basketball between Mac and Sunbelt. RedHawks with the ball coming out of the timeout. This is Larry, able to navigate up court without much pressure. Larry across the timeline. To the far wing, Larry bounces it into the post. Marambo shoulders his way to the basket. Marambo up top, can't get the shot to go, but does get the foul.
The foul is on Marshall.
Foul will be called for Marshall.
At the line, RedHawks, Anderson Marambo.
It looks like that was on Kinsey. And Marambo hits the first one, no problem. It'll be on Handlington, I beg your pardon. So Handlington takes back-to-back fouls. And Anderson Marambo now 4-for-4 from the line in the game with the second make. Leads down to 16. Travis Steele wants a little more pressure up front. And a foul's going to be called for Miami on Will Stevens, who's made his way into the game. He'll foul Kinsey coming up the court. Stevens, not a guy who's seen a lot of time for the RedHawks. The walk-on from Chicago appeared in one game this season, played 5 minutes against Goshen. Has been a great leader for this RedHawks team as he's going to be called for a second foul on the inbound.
Fouls on Miami's Will Stevens. That's his second.
And do you think this is something strategic maybe to bring in a guy who doesn't play a lot of minutes and try to maybe break up the game with some fouls, but not sure. Marshall will get this one in now, no problem. Here is Kinsey. Kinsey around the screen, top of the key, look for a pass that wasn't there, able to hang in the air and find Handlington, but he traveled on route to the basket. Kinsey does a great job. He almost looks for options when he's in midair. He jumps and then looks around, and that time he was just not able to find Handlington in the spot where he thought he was, and Handlington kind of with a weird drive. Quick steal, though, off the inbound, and Kinsey puts it up and in, and the foul.
Yeah, and Luke, I'm at a loss for words. I don't know what Lewis is seeing on this inbound. He tries to thread the needle past two defenders, one guy in his face, one guy on Makai Larry, to Makai Larry, and we've seen it not work time and time again, yet he keeps trying to do it. It's the definition of insanity. Lewis brings 115% to the floor, but he's got to start tapping into the brain a little bit because these turnovers are really starting to rack up for the RedHawks.
Three turnovers already in the opening four and change for the RedHawks here in the second half. And Kinsey able to get the good bounce off the rim and put that one in his home state. Tavion Kinsey now with 8 points. RedHawks in need of a response, lead is up to 19. Marambo from the left elbow, threads one down low. Stevens is blocked, but he gets the foul. And Will Stevens will head to the line.
The foul is on Marshall's Wyatt Fricks.
Foul will be on Wyatt Fricks. That's his second foul, team's fifth. And Will Stevens will head to the line. Stevens out of Chicago, played his high school ball in New England, won 3 New England championships. Puts the first one in. Multi-sport athlete, cross-country, rowing, football, golf, and basketball. And guess what his major is? East Asian language and culture. Very interesting guy, Will Stevens. Second one is no good, but a good offensive board by Lewis. He finds Yofin, 3-ball, too strong. Rebound fought for, Marambo got to it first, and he puts it up and gets the foul. Shot rolls off the rim. But Miami doing the things right that they need at this point in the game, getting some offensive boards.
Yeah, and Luke, we see Micah Honlington. He's got a lot of size down low, but pound for pound, Marambo's just out-toughing him. He's out-stronging him right now. Just he may have 3 inches on Marambo, but he cannot get a rebound to save his life right now, and Marambo has had a field day going one-on-one with number 5. from Marshall, and he's going to continue to, and you see finally comes out of the game for Marshall.
Arambo hits them both. Lead down to 16. Under 15 to play. Larry tried to get the steal on Taylor. He navigates it, knocks down the mid-range jumper. Marshall with a response of their own. Now Larry, left wing, top of the key. Marambo thought about the contested three-pointer. Instead, he hands it off to Lewis. Lewis back to Marambo. Now he'll take the top of the key three. No good. Rebound offensively for Miami by Stevens, but he can't get the layup to go. Picked up by Kinsey. Into the corner. Three ball. Connor knocks it in. Jacob Connor. What a night. Marshall by 21. Now quick three for Lewis. He hits. So as quick as the lead gets over 20, it's back down underneath it. Julian Lewis with a much needed three for the RedHawks. Now Fricks with a three of his own. How about it? NBA three-point contest right now. Marshall back in front by 21. And Wyatt Fricks now 4 for 5 from beyond the arc. Larry finds Marambo, hands it back to Larry, top of the key. Larry spins to the far side and just lost it. It was jabbed away from him. They're gonna say Marshall basketball. RedHawks flare up on their bench. And now the call is overturned. Larry will inbound from the baseline, 14 to shoot, 13:34 to go in the game. Billy Smith over to see the trainer for Miami. Off the inbound, Lewis has it at the logo. 8 to shoot. Lewis just goes up and under, nearly got it off the glass, but instead he'll head to the line. Really nice job by Julian Lewis, kind of stuck the arm underneath a couple of defenders and just flicked his wrist at the basket. Nearly got the shot to go. And with 13:26 to go, one positive for the RedHawks. They're now in the bonus. Seventh team foul for Marshall there, and Julian Lewis will shoot two on the shooting foul.
Yeah, and Lewis has been crafty all night, just getting looks that you wouldn't really draw up in the film room as being great looks, but he's been able to convert on enough of them that you feel comfortable with him being kind of just the ball handler that makes plays on the offensive end for Miami, and they're going to need him to continue that going forward.
Julian Lewis hits them both. He's got 9 points now for the RedHawks, including a perfect 4 for 4 from the line. RedHawks 15 for 17 from the charity stripe. Quick three, Fricks, no, off the iron. Rebound Stevens for the RedHawks. Quickly up to Lewis. Lewis trying to use the numbers, lost it, regained. Now he finds Yofin wide open. Left wing three is short and rebounded by Fricks, who got way above the basket. Left wing, Connor tried to alley-oop it, and a great tip on the ball made. A foul will be called, though, on Julian Lewis. Really good job by Lewis to prevent him from getting dunked on, getting posterized, but he will get called for the foul. On continuation of that play, as the two came to the ground, he and Emmerich Toussaint, who's now at the line. Toussaint to shoot two, and the first one off the mark. Emmerich Toussaint, one of many non-Americans who played at the Hoosac School in New York, played 5 years of high school after 4 at Freedom Christian Academy. And a second free throw short as well, rebounded by Eli Yofin. Yofin quickly up to Larry. Larry races to the basket. He's blocked by Toussaint. And now a ball thrown to the near side will be kicked by Miami and out of bounds. It'll be a kickball on the RedHawks. Larry's tried to make some drives at 5'8", but when you got a couple seven-footers on this Marshall roster, it just makes it really tough. Toussaint, not one of those seven-footers, but close at 6'10". And right now, Zach, we just see a swarm of black jerseys underneath the basket, seemingly on every RedHawk drive. On the far side, Taylor nearly lost it, and now he does. It's tipped away, though, by Mekhi Larry, who got last touch for the RedHawks. And Marshall will retain possession with 19 to shoot, 12:44 to go.
Marshall going extreme tempo right now. They've been able to get good looks. Feels like they need a bucket, though.
And they get the inbound alley-oop to Fricks. Completely uncovered underneath the basket. Fricks with his first two-pointer, 15 points for him now. Jaquel Morris has it for the RedHawks. Kicks into the corner for Will Stevens. Stevens jabs, double cover, tried to thread it down low for Morris, and that pass is taken away. Here comes Connor. Connor to the far side for Kinsey. Kinsey pulls up at the three-point line, now back for Connor. Connor two-hand pass to the far corner. Fricks thought about the three, instead he pulls it back down. Fricks has got it back now in the paint. Sky shot as he's falling goes in. Wyatt Fricks having a heck of a night. Larry gonna direct traffic now with Marshall leading by 23. Larry down the left lane, takes a hop, kicks into the corner, open look, Lewis for three, and that one rolls home. Timeout called by Travis Steele as Julian Lewis knocks down the three ball. And a 30-second timeout for Travis Steele to just calm his team down, it seems like, as slowly this lead has made its way back out to 20 points, Zach.
Yeah, and Luke, it just seems like whenever Miami responds with a punch, Marshall's got an even bigger jab up their sleeve. It just seems like no matter what Miami does, they can hit a three here, they can make a shot there, they can get a steal on the other side of the floor, but no matter what, guys like Fricks, Kinsley, all these guys, we can go down the line, obviously. Just seems like everyone's at will can score on this Marshall team, and that's what they've done, and they just keep growing this lead. And right now we're teetering around 20, 19, 21 points for the lead for Marshall, and it just seems like Travis Steele needs to break up the flow of the game. We still got 11:51 left, plenty of basketball to play, but Miami's got to slow down the tempo and just make things happen and stop letting Marshall do what they've done all night.
Marshall 6 for their last 7 from the floor. They're now up to 63.4% on field goals, 11 for 19 from 3. RedHawks haven't really improved a whole lot, still shooting under 30%. Miami's leading scorer continues to be Anderson Mirambo, who's got 17 points. Only other RedHawk in double figures is Julian Lewis, who now has 12. But no points in the second half so far for Makai Larry for the opening 8 minutes and 9 seconds. Miami down by 20 here in this second half. Just like to remind you, some broadcasts coming up over the next week or so. Miami football team stayed alive. We'll have their broadcast next week. Before that, Zach and I will be at Gainbridge Fieldhouse in Indianapolis on Sunday. Miami takes on the 12th-ranked Hoosiers from IU. Trace Jackson Davis, one of the leading candidates for potentially one of the best players in the country. RedHawks with a tall task in front of them. That game starts at 5:30 Eastern time on Sunday here on RedHawk Radio. And on Tuesday next week, Miami and Ball State in the annual Redbird rivalry with bowl eligibility on the line for both teams. Ball State 5-6, Miami 5-6. That game will get going at 7 p.m. Coverage will begin at 6:30 here on RedHawk Radio as Miami looks to be bowl eligible once again. After a trip last year to the Frisco Football Classic. Back here on the hardwood, Marshall's got possession of it, and out of the timeout, they're going to go back with another alley-oop, coming back down with it on the floor, though, and then finishing is Toussaint. Remember, Toussaint, who's seen more minutes here in this second half, picks up his first field goal of the night. For Miami, Lewis down the left lane, blocked by Toussaint. Loose ball picked up by Stevens for Miami. Larry, double-teamed, just sends it off a Marshall player and out. Really nice play there. Just shot it off the hip there of Connor into the Miami bench. A veteran presence there from Makai Larry, the 50-year senior. Second leading scorer last year for this RedHawks team. Leading scorer for them this year, averaging 19.3, including a 34-point performance against Georgia on Monday. 9 to shoot, Larry's got it. Sends up the three ball way to the left. Didn't hit the rim, off the backboard instead. Rebound scooped up by Toussaint off the floor. Here comes Taylor for Marshall. Taylor gets around the screen set by Toussaint to the far side. Taylor now jabs, makes his way in, sends a shot over Mitch Riley. That one's short. Riley gets the rebound for Miami. Larry up the near side. Across the timeline, Larry with a really nice move, gets around his man all the way to the rack, puts it off the glass and in. And a quick reach-in foul called on Eli Yofin as Andrew Taylor tried to race the other way. Yofin, a master we've seen all year of tipping balls loose. But we've seen him a couple times just get that hand in there, a little too much body, not enough ball. And he'll be called for another reach-in. 15 foul on the RedHawks. Marshall leading 70-50 with 10:41 to go, and they've got possession. On the drive, here's Kinsey, pulls up for mid-range, too strong. Rebounded for Miami by Lewis. Here's Julian Lewis. Between the legs, Lewis, step back three. Off the front of the iron, rebounded by Stevens. No look pass to Lewis underneath. Gets the foul and the roll. That one rolled all the way to the outside of the rim, looked like it was gonna fall off, and somehow found its way in. Beautiful rebound, by the way, by Will Stevens, who's done a great job in the offensive glass for the RedHawks over the last few minutes. And a chance to complete the old-fashioned three-point play at the line for Julian Lewis.
Yeah, great grab by Stevens, and an even better dish off there. No look, got it right to him, and able to get the roll just what the doctor ordered for Miami. They gotta capitalize, however.
And not pretty, but they can on the free throw. Julian Lewis needed three kicks off the rim, but got the shot to go. Marshall by 17, 10:20 to go. Here is Andrew Taylor. Floater pass to Toussaint now to the near side for Connor. Top of the key for Kinsey. Kinsey waves everybody off. He's got 8 points. Near side, long three by Connor. Off the meat of the iron and rebounded for Miami by Tatum. Tatum up the floor, finds Yofin into the corner, fake shot by Lewis. Met some contact, now Lewis is the ball stripped from his grasp by Connor. Going the other way for Marshall, a pass is tipped out of bounds by Yofin into the courtside seats here on the near side right in front of us. And the RedHawks unable to capitalize on the quick movement up the floor. Makai Larry will come in for Miami to replace Eli Yofin. Yofin, who's got three fouls. He will exit. Inbound into the near corner. Taylor on the drive up the baseline, lays it in. 17 points for Taylor. Check that, 19. Quick three for Larry. Off the inside of the rim and out. Rebounded by Hanlington. North Carolina native hands it to Taylor, who carries it up the court. Taylor back to Hanlington down low with the right hand, gets the foul. Rolled off the rim, though, to the far side. Two shots on the way for Micah Hendlington.
Miami's Will Stevens. That's his third. Tip foul number six.
Third team foul on, or third individual foul, I should say, on Will Stevens. 16 foul for the RedHawks.
Shooting two.
Two shots on the way for Micah Hendlington. And he's got his first make of the season. From the line, a host of subs for Miami. Billy Smith, Anderson Marambo, and Ryan Mabry come in. Julian Lewis, Bryson Tatum, and Mitchell Riley, 3, 4, and 5, numerically exit. Hanlington looking to go 2 for 2. He will not. Rebounded by Billy Smith for Miami. Here's Larry, across the timeline. Larry with some room, up the near side. Larry with a bullet pass to the far side that was tipped. But last touched off Ryan Mabry on its way out of bounds. It'll be Marshall ball with 9:18 to go. Hurd in front by 20. Camden Kerfman across the timeline, guarded by Ryan Mabry. Kerfman gets the screen, pulls up another logo three. This one won't go for him. Rebounded by Billy Smith for Miami. And we see no hesitation there from Kerfman to just take those looks early on in the shot clock. He's hit him so far tonight, not that time. Larry's pass is intercepted by Kerfman. Cross-court pass and an easy lay-in for Taylor on the fast break. 22-point lead for Marshall. 8:42 to go. Here's Makai Larry. Sends it top of the key for Marambo. Open three for Mabry. Little short. Rebound tipped in the air by Kinsey and secured by Hanlington for Marshall. Quick ball movement up the floor to the near corner. Three ball is no good from Jacob Connor. And a push on the rebound will give the ball to Marshall on the baseline.
The foul's on Miami's Anderson Marambo.
Foul on Marambo. His first 17 foul. Official initially signaled for an inbound for Marshall, but they will be in the bonus now. So it'll instead be a 1-1 for Micah Hanlington. Hanlington, whose father played in the MAC at Western Michigan. Can't hit it. Marambo on the rebound. Marshall, not a good free throw shooting team. 67% coming into this one, 46% today. Marambo thundering down the lane with the skyhook, puts it in.
Nice little shot fake and go for Marambo. Like that drive on the lane.
And a quick move down low, backdoor cut. Shot is no good from Hamilton. Gets his own rebound, skies one up. Tried to alley-oop for Kinsey. Loose ball on the floor, picked up by Connor for Marshall. Open three now on the far side for Taylor. He knocks it down.
And Miami unlucky there. That was a very clear foul against, I believe it was Makai Larry. If not, it was Brian Mabry, but they were being held as the ball was kind of rolling around near the three-point line. They were very clearly being grabbed and not called by the refs, unfortunately, but the Thundering Herd lived to see another day and then knocked down another three. And how about Taylor? Really quiet 24, but it's been meaningful for Marshall, and that's really been the difference in this one.
Yeah, Andrew Taylor out of Corbin, Kentucky, fifth-year senior, who started every single game for Marshall since he was declared eligible, initially committed to Furman, then decommitted from Furman in June after his senior year, decided to commit to Marshall in July with school beginning in August. Because of that, and already signing his NLI, he was ineligible. Did not become eligible till halfway through his freshman year. Since then, he has started every single game for Marshall over the last four and a half years, I should say. They ran a promotion before they started playing music. There was a brief stoppage, and an audibly frustrated Travis Steele in the Miami huddle was heard throughout Millett Hall, I'm sure. Steele, a guy who's been very vocal all night, heard some things that would not make listeners very happy over the air earlier on in this one. Travis Steele in his first season with Miami, looking to give the RedHawks their first Division I win, 1-2 on the year. Losses to Georgia out of the SEC, Evansville out of the Missouri Valley. Defeated NAIA opponent Goshen last weekend. Marshall finally under 60% shooting, 57.7% from the floor. But you saw in that last possession, sometimes they're missing these shots, but it's rebounds on rebounds, and it seems like they're getting points every time they go up the floor. And they'll get a chance for some more here coming out of this timeout.
And one thing I've noticed, Luke, an oddity for basketball. It's not really anything good, bad, or indifferent. It's just that Travis Steele and his staff, if you give them 30 seconds on a timeout, they're going to use every bit of that 30 seconds and then some. And same with full timeouts with the minute 30 they're allotted. They use every little bit of it. And they are always the last ones on the floor, and they're fine with that. They just need the extra time to talk things over, it seems like.
So the RedHawks down by 23 here with 7:43 to go. Smith to the near side for Will Stevens. Stevens hands to Larry. Larry going to drive the baseline, kick to the far corner, maybe with the contested three. He stepped on the line, and it will be Marshall ball. RedHawks, who only turned the ball over eight times in the entirety of that first half, just picked up their eighth turnover here in the second half in just a little bit more than half the time. 7:30 to go here in half number two. Marshall leading by 23 with the ball. Camden Kerfman finds Hamilton on the logo, who will start the offense up. Back to Kerfman on the far side in front of the Marshall bench. Heaves one right underneath the basket. Fadeaway shot is good for Kinsey, and the foul. It hasn't come in bunches like it usually has for Tavion Kinsey tonight, Zach, but we've seen the offensive talent clearly there for the Columbus native. He's got a chance at the line for a three-point play.
Yeah, Luke, he's showing off the vertical. I'd love to see when this guy is just trying to jump as high as possible what he can get, because on a jump shot, it looks like he's getting well into the 2.5-3 feet range just on a jump shot. I would love to see what this guy can do, because I think he could touch the top of the backboard if he absolutely wanted to.
Knock down the free throw. Quickly, Miami will come the other way. Here is Larry spinning to the basket. Crafty bounce to the corner. Stevens thought about the three, took too long. Now he finds Mabry on the right wing. Three ball, no. Stevens will touch that one into Marshall's hands. It'll be tipped out of bounds and be Miami ball. Micah Handlington went down, thought he drew the foul, but instead it'll be an inbound for the RedHawks after the last touch came from Marshall. Yeah, back to your point, Zach, earlier on about Kinsey. We talked about him making plays. He's got this move he does where he doesn't look at where he's going to pass, and then he jumps and then surveys the court, and he looks to just float and just be suspended in midair. Really impressive stuff. Right underneath the basket, they found Smith again, and he gets fouled. That play's worked a couple times for Miami. It was a little cleaner last time. They ran it, got Smith an easy bucket. This time, he's able to draw the foul and head to the line. Ninth team foul for Marshall. It'll be called on Taylor. Billy Smith will shoot two.
Yeah, and Luke, with the success that we've seen Marshall have, if I were them and our coach Santoni, I'd run some variation of an alley-oop every play. I mean, they've got so much size. They're running their forward point guard mix and Kinsey on an alley-oop play, and he looks more than comfortable doing it. You start getting guys like Connor in on that. Even Fricks could do that as well. I just don't see how they're not going to be contending for a Sun Belt championship with that, with the playmaking ability and the size they have on their roster.
RedHawks hit both the free throws. There was a foul called on Will Stevens underneath the basket as they were fighting for the would-be rebound, had Billy Smith missed that second free throw. And what a funny night it's been for Will Stevens. He's been very good. He's not a guy who sees a lot of minutes usually. He's got 9 minutes here in the second half and four fouls through it. And now he's going to come off the floor. Respectable effort there from Will Stevens, though. The senior out of Chicago, a guy that you love to see if you're a Miami fan, see the floor. Guy who's been a mainstay on this roster for so long. Getting some much-deserved time on the court. Connor hands off for Taylor for Marshall. Taylor bounces it down low, going for the up and under. Handlington's blocked out of bounds, but the Herd will retain possession.
Yeah, and Luke, death taxes and Anderson Morambo getting the best of Hoglington. It just, he's not been able to draw up anything that 45 hasn't had an answer to. And that's been the story for number five for Marshall.
That time, Morambo bested by Kinsey, who put it off the glass and in right in his face as Miami tried to move it back the other way. Makai Leary was fouled. Kinsey will be called for the reach-in on the counter up the floor. 10th team foul for Marshall. Miami now in the double bonus, so Makai Leary will shoot two. Miami down 83-57. And there's the first miss of the year from Kyle Leary.
And Luke, it just seems like one of those nights for the RedHawks. They put up a valiant effort in the first half, and they continued it a little bit, played a little more sloppy in the second half. But no matter what they've thrown at the Marshall Thundering Herd, they have not been able to get over the hump and eclipse the lead or even really get close. Things have just kind of gone bad to worse, and they have no answer for it right now, do the RedHawks.
Leary hit the second, 83-58. Three ball fadeaway is good for Kerfman on the flip side. Things going really well still for Marshall, still shooting over 50% from deep. Morambo, top of the key. Smith thought about the three, caught some contact. Foul is called on Connor. Marshall bench flaring, livid on the far side. It'll be the third foul on Jacob Connor, and it'll send Billy Smith to the line. RedHawks have been good, as they always are, from the free throw line, but from the field is where they've really struggled. Kind of righted the ship a little bit. They're over 30% now from the field at 17 for 56. Smith knocks the first one down. But 5 for 27 from three, and a team that Travis Steele said preseason has been known as a shooting team, thought they were a shooting team, thought that was their identity. They've really struggled to shoot the three ball, both in that Evansville game and in this one. You look at some of the top guys for the RedHawks as Smith knocks the second one down. Smith 0 for 4 from deep, Mabry 0 for 3, Leary 0 for 6.
Yeah, and Luke, I think it's a mix of bad shot selection. They've settled a lot this year, and just they haven't been able to get in enough of an offensive rhythm for any of their individual guys to find a rhythm from the arc.
Really nice up and under there from Taylor, who ran the whole perimeter of the court to find the two. Marshall up 88-60 here with 5:46 to go. Smith sent one in. It was tipped away from Morris, but he'll re-secure it back in the backcourt. Now he hands to Mabry. Mabry will make his way to the top of the key. Guarded closely by Fricks. Mabry gets around him and a really nice finish with the left hand. Ryan Mabry, normally a shooter, but he's shown some flashes of brilliance on drives tonight. That pass slung underneath the basket. Fricks did his best and somehow kept it in for the moment, but then finally lost it out of bounds. Fricks has just had his nose in there all night. That time, though, he can't get the luck he's had throughout the evening. And on the inbound for the RedHawks, it's a miss in front of Ryan Mabry that goes into the Marshall bench. And it'll be turned right back over to the Herd. Ninth turnover of the second half for the RedHawks. Inbound from Taylor out to the logo for Connor. Near wing to Kerfman. Kerfman bouncing it into the high post for Kinsey. Kinsey turns his way into the paint. Threads it underneath for Connor, who got down low and put it off the right side of the glass and in. Jacob Connor with 12 points, the Dayton native. A struggle for Miami. Out of the trap, they eventually find Mabry on the near side. Contested deep three is not going to go for Mabry. And rebounded by Jacob Connor. Kinsey with the handoff to Kerfman. Kerfman floats it up top for Kinsey. Kinsey spins, fades. Off the iron, no good. Rebounded for Miami by Jacquel Morris. Now Mabry. Mabry to the wing. Lewis jabs, doesn't get much space. Sends it into the post. Turnaround pass by Morris underneath is picked off by Connor. Connor ahead for Kinsey. Kinsey on the drive falls to the court. Found a man down low, but a foul is called before that on him.
Fouls on Miami is Billy Smith.
It'll be on Billy Smith. Shame for Kinsey that that play did not continue, because as he was falling, he made a really nice desperation pass and found a wide open Wyatt Fricks underneath the basket. Would have had an easy finish, but instead it'll be two shots at the free throw line for Kinsey. And the first one rolls around the rim and no good. David Early, the West Virginia native, lone West Virginia native on this Marshall roster, will come in now for the Herd. RedHawks will bring in Bryson Tatum and Mitchell Riley. Second free throw is nothing but net. 91-62, Herd on top. 4:14 to go. And a game that quickly got out of hand here in the second half. Tatum, top of the key to Riley. Riley back to Tatum on the wing. Tatum with some space now, sends to Smith. Contested left wing three. Off the front rim and rebounded by David Early for the Herd. Tavion Kinsey sends up the far wing. Connor back for Early. Early to the near side for Fricks, who floats his way to the top of the key. Now Kinsey on the far side, sends it into the corner. Connor surveys, cross court to the near wing. Early now drives far side, can't get the roll around the rim. Rebounded for Miami by Billy Smith, racing up the floor on the near side. Mabry with a no-look pass to Yofin for three. That one is no good, and rebounded for Marshall by David Early. Early to the far side for Kerfman, back to Early. Had a wide open shot, instead elect to pass to Kinsey. Got it back though. Now hands off at half court to Kerfman. Kerfman holding on to it, 3:11 to go in the game. 10 to shoot for Marshall, tried to send up an alley-oop there for Fricks, but he was not on the same page, and it will head out of bounds. Well, this one has gotten high scoring on one side. Marshall has eclipsed the 90-point mark here with 3:08 to go in half number two. We'll be back from Oxford in a moment. Stay with us. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. We'll be right back. court has been tipped in one direction here at Millett. Marshall leading Miami 91-62 in the late going second half. 3:08 to go in the game. Luke West, Poley, Zach Rengers alongside. First of three games in 5 days for the Herd. They will start a five-game homestand on Saturday as they will host Coppin State. But overall, Zach, showing that I think Dan D'Antoni is going to be really, really happy with for his team on the road against an old rival.
Yeah, and how can you not if you're Coach D'Antoni? Your team shot the lights out of the building. You've gotten in transition, made plays, and you've made some really nice, just all-around effort plays, it feels like, in this game. You've got everyone into the mix. You've subbed a bunch of guys in the game, got freshmen, some valuable reps here at Miami, and you pick up an almost 30-point win when it's all said and done. You got to be happy with that performance.
Pass is tipped into the corner, intended for Smith. It'll go into the Miami bench. It'll remain Red Hawk ball. 2:58 to go, 20 to shoot for Miami. As for the Red Hawks, they will have an even tougher task ahead of them as they will take on Indiana, currently ranked 12th in the nation. That'll be on Sunday, neutral site at Gainbridge Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Indianapolis native Billy Smith with the rock in his hands. He sends it into the corner. Driving is Tatum. Mid-range jumper is off the mark, rebounded by Early for the Herd. Over to the far side, Kerfman settling it down. Marshall, who played at breakneck speed earlier on, slowing things down a bit here in the later goings, trying to milk clock. Fricks, turnaround look underneath is no good. Put back attempt by Kinsey over top of the basket. Yofin crashed into Early, and a foul will be called on him. So Yofin with the draw, just turned around. There was a man standing right there in a wall that ran over Eli Yofin. He will head to the line to shoot two.
And Luke, I've never seen a bench full of coaches work the refs harder than the crew that D'Antoni has assembled for Marshall. It's rain, sleet, snow, rain for them. It could be the most blatant foul you've ever seen, and you're still getting moans and groans from their bench. I mean, credit to them, honestly, because it takes some real, you have to really be committed to it, and they've stuck to their guns, which is just working the refs as hard as possible, and they've given them all they can handle tonight.
An ovation for some good performances on the Herd side is the starters' exit. First free throw was missed by Yofin. Second one on the way, and that one bounces up and away, no good. Rebounded for Marshall by Miladinovic. The Montenegrin has got the ball in his hands now. Miladinovic, or rather Kerfman, now to the far side. Kyle Braun freshly checked into the game. Early on the offensive foul, he'll be called. Got some great names on these foreign guys for Marshall. You've got Goran Miladinovic and Marko Sharanic, spelled S-A-R-E-N-A-C, a Serbian. Love to see the Europeans getting into college basketball. Always love to see the representation from around the world. Mostly see it for Miami Hockey, who picked up two new European recruits today. Love to see it on the hardwood as well. Tatum went down to the baseline. He's blocked. Miladinovic sends it to the far side for Sharanic. Miladinovic to the corner. Thiemann, no good on the three. Rebound by Miladinovic outside the arc. Back into the corner. Kyle Braun thought about the shot. Instead, he'll pass that one off to Thiemann. Creighton Thiemann, Louisville native. Played at Trinity and South Oldham in high school. Kyle Braun on the three, that one no good. Rebound by Miladinovic, and the big seven-footer puts it back and in. Goran Miladinovic with his first points of the season. 93-62, Marshall with 71 seconds remaining. Here's Yofin to the near side. Open three look for Tatum, and he connects. Beg your pardon. Tatum on the three. We'll make it a 93-65 game with under a minute to play. Sending it to the far side. It's picked up by Sharanic. Now pull it back out for David Early. Early drives on Mabry. Early with a high ball over the head of the intended target in Creighton Thiemann. And that's out of bounds. Yofin will inbound for the Redhawks with 46 seconds left. A foul is called on the inbound. It'll be on David Early. And the Redhawks will shoot. And again, a little frustration on the Marshall side. It's going to be all smiles, though, on the 3.5-hour bus ride home for the Thundering Herd up by 28 here late. Marshall going to get to play their next five games in the friendly confines of Huntington, West Virginia. Bryson Tatum at the line to shoot two for the RedHawks. He'll connect on the first.
And if you're Miami here, you're just looking to build up a little bit of momentum. Obviously, you got a very, very tall task in taking on Indiana. Luckily for you, it is at somewhat of a neutral site, and you're just trying to look for something to build on. Obviously, Bryson Tatum hitting a couple nice shots and a couple free throws there, something that you can certainly talk about going into the next game.
RedHawks 82% from the line tonight. Running across the court, Braun had it stripped away, regained it, made his way into the mid-range where he put up a shot. It was no good. Rebound collected by Miladinovic, and he puts it in. Hasn't played all night. He looks to be a force underneath the basket, though. He's collected a couple offensive rebounds with ease. Didn't even jump. The big seven-footer. Goran Miladinovic. Shot and game clock separated by a couple tenths of a second. Mabry with the left hand all the way around and puts it in down the lane. Another crafty left-handed finish. Marshall tried to throw that ball to us on the inbound. It'll be Miami ball after the turnover. You maybe could have reached out with your left hand and caught that ball, Zach.
Yeah, I'm a little tired, Luke. It's been a long week.
It has indeed. We'll get a couple rest days before we hit the road for Sunday. From the baseline, Bryson Tatum finds Smith in the corner. 13 on the game clock. Smith tried to drive, had that one pried away. Loose ball at center court, tipped, and eventually it finds Yofin. Yofin skies one to Mabry, who will take the three from the wing. Way too strong. And rebounded by Marshall, who will dribble this one out. That's her final here from Millett Hall. Back and forth performance throughout the first half, but the Herd took control over the final 20 minutes. Marshall comes away with an emphatic victory here in Oxford. 95-69 is your final, as the Herd over 500 now, 2-1 on the season. They will take on Coppin State, as mentioned at the beginning of a five-game homestand on Saturday before beginning their inaugural Sun Belt season against Appalachian State just before New Year's. For the RedHawks, they fall to 1-3 on the year, and they will hit the road for a neutral site against Indiana. That'll be a 5:30 start from Gainbridge Fieldhouse this Sunday afternoon. RedHawks will be back at home next Saturday as they will take on the Trojans from Arkansas Little Rock. That'll be a 1 p.m. tip here from Millett Hall. Overall, Zach, we mentioned it at the halftime break. It wasn't a bad effort at the time for the RedHawks, but you face a hot shooting team, and then in the second half, you find yourselves in a hole, and they really just let the game get away from the lead.
Yeah, and that was really the storyline. They matched, if not bested, Marshall's effort to start the game, and then Marshall shot the absolute lights out of Millett Hall tonight, and then really pulled away in the early stages of that second half, and that was all it took for Marshall. It just seemed like they had the edge both in shooting tonight and just the guys on the floor. I mean, you talk about it, sometimes that's enough, and they had really talented players that were bigger than Miami's guys, and they were able to just get shots here and there to fall, and that was the storyline in that one, and you just chalk it up as not being ready to go against the Marshall team that's hungry. They're starting a new conference, a new season and a new conference this year, and they're looking to get out on the right foot, and that's exactly what they did at Millett Hall. You got to move on, be road warriors if you're Miami.
Yeah, a lot of talent on this Marshall team. That's been very clear. Some question marks going into their season in a new conference as to how they would stack up with a lot of realignment in the Sun Belt, but some veteran presence, as we mentioned in the open, Zach, and those guys really seems like know the game of college basketball very well. Marshall, very physical. You talked about their size down low, but shot the absolute lights out, like you mentioned. Would you believe me if I said towards the tail end of this game, Marshall cooled down to 50% from three-point range instead of the 60% numbers near that they were shooting in the early goings of this one? Marshall finished with a 56.1% mark from the field on a route to a tremendous victory by 26 points here in Oxford. Well, Zach, this was an interesting game, to say the least. We had some anticipation, thought it might be a little closer, thought it kind of was a little closer than maybe the scoreboard showed, but at the end of the day, things just not cutting it for the RedHawks. Your final thoughts on this one before we hit the road in Indy on Sunday?
Yeah, RedHawks just have to find a way to get the ball in the hoop more often. They just could not shoot for the lives of them in that game, and that was really the issue going down the stretch. They started off slow. You thought maybe it could have been remedied by some better shooting in the second half, and it seemed like shooting got worse. Shot selection has to be better. You have to find guys in the right spot to shoot the ball. Obviously, you're fine with a heat check here and there from Rambo, but you don't want him to be your main three-point shooter at points in the game. You want to get it to Mabry. And speaking of Mabry, we haven't seen Ryan Mabry get into his rhythm. We know that this guy was an all-conference shooter in high school. He was one of the better guys to come into this freshman class from Miami. We haven't seen him and many others get really hot from three-point range. It's about time for those guys to start to heat up, and it's just a matter of time, it feels like, before that happens for this Red Hawk team.
Yeah, absolutely. Travis Steele raved about Ryan Mabry's three-point shooting ability. He struggled in that first game, and Coach Steele said he's not going to tell him to stop shooting because that's his game. Ryan Mabry came into this one shooting just over 20%, but 0 for 5 from beyond the arc in what was just an overall abysmal performance from the Red Hawks from deep. 6 for 32 for an 18.8% mark for Miami from deep. And that's certainly not going to cut it, like Zach said, especially against the team they're going to have to face off against on Sunday. Red Hawks will be against Indiana from Gainbridge Fieldhouse Sunday afternoon and evening. That game will start at 5:30. We'll begin our coverage at 5:15 here on Red Hawk Radio, as Zach and I will have the call of that one. That'll do it here tonight from Oxford for us. Miami falling in this one in dominant fashion to Marshall. 95-69 is your final. We'll see you in Indy on Saturday. Until then, for all of our hardworking crew here at Red Hawk Radio, this is Luke West Poley saying so long and good night. Thanks for tuning in here from Millett Hall.